Hello friends, in our previous video, we have already discussed the shortcut method to determine what is the effect of the input and output impedance by the negative feedback. Now let us solve one numerical based on that topic. A series shunt feedback amplifier employs a basic amplifier with input and output resistances each of 2 kilo ohm. That means for basic amplifier block, both the input and output resistance are 2 kilo ohm and gain A equal to 1000 volt per volt. So see, the unit is volt per volt. That means output is in voltage and input is also in voltage. So basically we are giving the input as some voltage value and we are also getting the voltage value. So basically this amplifier is nothing but voltage amplifier. Okay. The feedback factor beta equal to 0.1 volt per volt. Find the gain AF, that is closed loop gain or gain with feedback, and the input resistance RIF and the output resistance ROF of the closed loop amplifier. Here F stands for feedback. Clear? So the first step to solve this type of numerical is just draw the block diagram of the feedback amplifier which is given in the question. See, this is series shunt. That means input is in series, that is mixing network is basically in series, and the output network, the shunt network is basically this sampling network is basically shunt. So this is basically voltage sampling, voltage mixing feedback topology. Let us see, we have to draw the, in the first step we have to draw the feedback topology. See, here in the input side this is series type, mixing is series one, and the sampling network is basically shunt type. So this is series shunt feedback topology. Now we have to determine the overall gain. So we know the formula for the overall gain of the negative feedback as AF equal to A by 1 plus A times beta. Clear? Or G by 1 plus GH, as you say. So A is basically 1000. So substitute, just simple substitution of values. So you will get 1000 by 1 plus 1000 into what is beta? Beta is 0.1. Clear? Solve this by calculator. You will get AF as 9.9 volt per volt. Clear? Now see the next question is input resistance. See, the input is in series, and I told you that if something is in series then the resistance increases, and any increment in the feedback amplifier module can be simply multiplication of 1 plus A times beta. So the new impedance or new resistance of the input side will be Ri into 1 plus A times beta. Clear? So solve this by calculator. What is Ri? Ri is 2 kilo ohm. Ri, Rout, both are 2 kilo ohm into 1 plus 1000 into 0.1. Clear? And the unit is in kilo ohm because this is 2 kilo ohm. Okay. So solve this by calculator. You will get the new input impedance with application of the feedback amplifier is basically 202 kilo ohm. And the output impedance, what will be the output impedance? It is shunt, and in shunt the impedance decreases, and I told you any decrease can be expressed in terms of division divided by 1 plus A beta. So this will be R out by 1 plus A beta, where R out is the output resistance without application of the feedback. So what is the answer? It will be 2 kilo ohm by 1 plus 1000 into 0.1, because A is 1000 and beta is 0.1. Solve this by calculator. You will get result as 19.8 ohm. Clear? So basically what we are getting? We are getting the output impedance is decreased and the value is 19.8 ohm. Input impedance is increased and the value is 202 kilo ohm, and the overall gain decreases with respect to or compared to the open loop gain, and it becomes 9.9 volt per volt. So the idea is very simple. To solve this type of numericals, first draw the feedback topology, then if anything is in series connection, multiply that impedance by 1 plus A beta, and if it is in shunt connection, divide that by 1 plus A beta. Okay, this is how you have to solve this type of numericals. I will show more examples in my next videos. This is all for this video. Thank you for watching.